Okay, class. In this chapter, by far we have seen what equators are, what latitudes and longitudes are. The imaginary lines that passes from the globe are known as latitudes and longitudes. The one that is passing from north to pole, south, is latitude, and the one from east to west is longitude. And we have also seen some important latitudes like equator. And then we have seen how equator divides the globe into northern and southern hemisphere. We have also seen how 0° longitude divides the earth into eastern and western hemisphere. So we were discussing about the important longitudes that, and we have also discussed prime meridian, that is 0° longitude, which passes from the Greenwich in England. And it divides the globe into two parts, that is the eastern and western hemisphere. Now in this video we are going to see about the international dateline. It is also an important longitude, and we are also going to see how the local time is calculated, and how when this local time is calculated, it needs to be standardized. Means everyone should follow a same time zone, right? If it doesn't happen so, then there would be confusion, right? So how the standard time is calculated? In this video, we are going to discuss about this three topic, that is international dateline, which is one of the important longitudes. And then we are going to see how we are calculating the local time and standard time.
So there is only one 180° longitude, that is international date line. And when one crosses this line, the day and the date both changes. This international date line passes through the Pacific Ocean and separates two calendar dates. Not exactly 180° at all places, but the problem is this 180° longitude is not equal at all the places, and it is crisscross line across several time zones. So this is because if it is drawn straight, then the line has to pass through many islands, and due to this they might have 2 days and two dates on the same island. Means if you draw this international date line straight, then what will happen, that many island through which this line passes will have 2 days and two dates on the same island, which might create confusion and problem will arise. So this line is drawn in a zigzag manner, shifted towards water bodies, and so it is not straight but zigzag. Here in this dotted line you can see how international date line passes, which is not straight at all the places, it is zigzag, because to avoid the confusion. Otherwise it will happen that the island would have same date and dates, two dates on the same island. Okay, so this is international date line. This is your homework, children. You have to try to find the longitudinal coordinates of these countries that are given. For you, India is already given. Rest you have to find out. This is one of your homework. So in earlier days it is said that sun was used to calculate the time. So sun is the biggest clock of the earth. The time at any place is decided by the position of the sun in the sky and its longitude. When earth completes one rotation, you know, right? How much time does earth takes to complete one rotation? It is 24 hours. And there are 360 longitudes in all. We have seen, right? 180 to the east of prime meridian and 180 towards the west. I have explained you. So in this way 15 longitude passes by the sun in 1 hour. So when the earth completes rotation in 24 hours, 15 longitude passes by the sun in 1 hour. So one longitude takes 4 minutes to travel. So there will be difference of 4 minutes between two adjacent longitudes. So the time in different places on the earth varies for as per their longitude. Okay, in this activity, children, you have to write which country is ahead or behind India according to time. Means here the country names are given. For example, here Nepal is given. You have to calculate whether it is ahead or behind the time in the country. So here for Nepal it is ahead. No, Nepal is actually has the same time as India. It has accepted the standard time of India. In the similar way, you have to try find out for other countries that are given here. Just try. If you are not able to find, it's okay. I will explain you how it is done. Okay, now here we will see about local time. So the time is usually taken according to overhead position of the sun in a particular place. So that is what local time of that place. It differs by 4 minutes in every 1 degree longitude. So the places in the same longitude will have same time. So if the difference is of 4 minutes with every 1 degree longitude, when any longitude faces the sun directly, it would be the noon time, that is 12 o'clock in that longitude. So in this way, the local time of place is decided according to what? The overhead position of sun, that is mid noon. The places located on same longitude have the same time, and places located at different longitudes in the same country have different time. In a country, if a local time is different in different places, it can create problem in administration. So agar ek hi country mein alag alag time se sab chale, time zone alag ho, to kya hoga? Will create problem. So we have to work out a solution. That is when standard time came in. So local time was calculated from mid noon. That is, it would be happen that if the country has different places lie on different longitudes, then the time zone will be different. So to overcome this problem, we have a standard time. We will see what it is. So the local time of place which is situated in the middle of the country. So in the middle of the country which place comes, the local time of that place is taken as the standard time of a country. This means that the time is fixed on the basis of particular longitude in a country. That is standard time. So if you discuss about the standard time of our country, then it is based on 82.5 degree east longitude, and that passes from Allahabad in Uttar Pradesh. That is, when 12 noon in Allahabad happens, then the entire country will have 12 noon. Okay, this makes it more convenient to administrate or administration of the country to work smoothly. So I hope you are clear with all the terms that are explained in both the videos. If you have any doubt, you can ask me. First of all, read the complete lesson, go through this video more than 2 times, then I hope that you will understand the lesson better. Try to do that both activities that I have given you as homework. Just try. If you get the answer, it's well and good. If you don't get the answer, I'm there to help you. Thank you.